Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a Google Ads report in Looker Studio. The report will give you a top-level view of all of your campaigns, so you can easily compare results across search, display, performance max, and any other campaign types you're running. We're going to build a clear side-by-side report that helps you monitor performance at a glance. To do this, we'll use a mix of charts and scorecards, and we'll also add filters so you can refine what's included in the charts. You'll walk through the steps to create the report using the responsive layout option, which means your report will automatically adjust to different screen sizes, so it looks great on desktop and mobile. Okay, let's jump in and start building this report together. I've already opened Looker Studio, but if you're just getting started, you can head to lookerstudio.google.com. And to create a new report, let's click Blank Report. Now we need to add a data source to our report. Since we're creating a report for our Google Ads campaigns, let's select Google Ads. Now you will need to select your Google Ads account. I'm going to select my demo account. Now let's click Add. And Add to Report. We now need to select the type of layout we want to use for the report. Selecting Freeform means that the pages in the report and the charts will be a fixed size. Selecting Responsive means the report and charts will automatically adjust based on screen size. For this report, let's select Responsive Layout. Now let's name the report. Let's name it Google Ads Campaigns. And since we selected Responsive Layout for our report, we can also see there is a placeholder for a report title. So let's also adjust this and name it Google Ads Campaigns. Since I'm using my Google Ads demo property as the data source, I'm going to begin by adjusting the date range by selecting the date range control at the top. I'm only adjusting the date range to show you a more interesting set of data. When you connect your Google Ads account, you won't need to do this. Okay, now let's click Add Chart. And let's select Scorecard. We can see this has added a scorecard showing us the total number of clicks on our ads. Let's make a couple of adjustments to this. First, let's add a comparison so we can quickly see if the number of clicks is going up or down. To do this, let's ensure the chart is selected, and then on the Setup tab on the right, let's look for the Comparison Date Range option. And let's enable this. Now let's select None. We can see the calendar selector. And now let's click None again. And for this report, I'm going to select Previous Period, which will compare the current date range to the same number of preceding days. However, if you would prefer to see a year-on-year comparison, you can select Previous Year. Now let's click Apply. We can now see the percentage change for the metric is included in the scorecard. Okay, now let's make one more adjustment. We can see the name of the metric is repeated in the scorecard, so let's remove this duplication. To do this, let's select the Style tab. And scrolling down, let's look for Labels. And let's enable the Hide Field Name option. That's looking good, so now let's duplicate the scorecard. To do this, we select Edit and then Duplicate. And we can also use the keyboard shortcut. Now let's change the metric. To do this, let's select the current metric on the Setup tab. And let's search for and select Impressions. Let's duplicate the scorecard again. and let's select cost as the metric. Let's duplicate the scorecard again. And let's select conversions as the metric. Let's duplicate it again. And select conversion rate. And let's duplicate the scorecard one more time. And let's select total conversion value. We now have a top-level summary for all of our Google Ads campaigns at the top of the report. Next, we're going to add a chart that allows us to quickly compare the different types of campaigns from our account. To do this, we need to add another row to our report. So let's click the plus sign while we hover just under the scorecards. Now let's add a vertical bar chart to the report. And let's change the dimension. Let's search for and select advertising channel type. And now let's ensure the metric is set to clicks. We can now see which type of campaigns are driving the most clicks through to our website. Apart from clicks, you might want to focus on cost, conversions, or even add multiple metrics to the chart to see everything at a glance. Now let's add a table to our report. This is going to give us a more detailed look at each campaign's performance. Let's change the dimension to campaign. This lets us see all of the campaigns, but this time by their name in our report. Now let's adjust the columns in the chart. Let's adjust the table so it shows clicks, cost, and conversions. We can now see a breakdown of these metrics by campaign. Okay, but you've probably noticed there are some rows in the table that are just showing zeros. And even in the bar chart, there are some campaign types showing zeros too. These are from inactive campaigns. So to clean up our report, let's add a filter to these charts. With the table selected, let's look for Filter in the Setup tab. And let's click Add Filter. Let's name the filter Eligible Campaigns Only. Let's leave Include selected. And for the field, let's search for and select Campaign Status. Let's select equal to for the condition and enter eligible. Let's select this. This will mean any paused or removed campaigns won't be included in the chart. Now let's save the filter. We can see our table updates to only include active campaigns. Let's apply the same filter to our bar chart. Let's select the chart. Look for filters. Select Add Filter and choose the filter we just created. We've now cleaned up the bar chart too. Do you usually report at the campaign type level, or do you prefer more detailed campaign or ad group level reports? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear how you would like to use Looker Studio for reporting. Next, let's add another row to our report. And let's add a time series chart. Let's adjust the chart so it shows clicks and cost as the metrics. This lets us quickly identify any interesting trends in our selected date range. Now let's add one more row. And let's add a table. We're going to use this table to show us keywords from our search campaigns, along with how many clicks each keyword has received. So let's change the dimension to search keyword. And let's ensure the metric is set to clicks. You could also adjust the table to include additional metrics. For example, you might want to include the average cost per click, click-through rate, conversions, and other metrics. Let's add one more chart to our report. Let's add a heat map. And let's ensure this is showing us country, territory, along with clicks. This shows us where our clicks are coming from. Again, you might want to adjust which metric is shown in the chart. We've now built a clean, responsive Google Ads report that compares your campaigns and gives you real insights at a glance. If you'd like to get a pre-built copy of this report, you can find a link in the description below this video. I recommend taking some time to customize the report further to meet your particular reporting needs. And I would love to hear how you make the report your own. Let me know in the comments below. To learn more about Looker Studio and Google Ads, please take a moment to check out my courses and subscribe to this channel for all of the latest updates. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.